best in me.
Yes.
Who saw the best in me? The Lord Jesus Christ saw the best in me.
That's right.
He only sees me for who I am.
That's right. That was Marvin Sapp on Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show. He saw the best in me. Best in Me is the name of the song. What a blessing for the Lord to always see the best in all of us.
Man.
We want to give a shout out to Evangelist Shantae Kelly, who couldn't make it tonight. She's doing some things with her church. But we still want to give a shout out to her on the Midnight Hour Radio Show.
Hey, Evangelist.
She'll be coming back next week on the Midnight Hour Radio Show, Gospel Creations. You know, this week Our message is 1 John 1:9. This is the ESV, English Standard Version. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You see, a lot of people think that they got to cleanse themselves before they come to the Lord. But he don't need you to cleanse yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You can come to him dirty. You can come to him being a crackhead, an adulterer.
You can come to him. You are.
That's right, right, being a drug dealer,
right,
a nymphomaniac, a stripper, whatever you is, homosexual, whatever. It don't matter. The Lord is there for all of us, and he can only see the best in you.
Right.
And he will cleanse your soul and bring out the best in you if you believe in him and you had a faith. I'm going to turn it over to Brother Michael G.
I think the second part of that scripture that says he is faithful, that part right there, meaning you can come to him at any time. You don't have to wait until church start. You don't have to wait until you're surrounded by pastors or bishops or people to lay hands on you. If he's faithful and just to forgive you, that means he's always there. He's going to be there. It's guaranteed that he's going to be right there if you confess your sins. He's faithful and just, meaning that he's not looking at you to come to you. You know, sometimes you can go to people and they're judging you as you're walking to them. And you've been in situations where people are just starting to make comments about you or comments about your life or who you are as you're approaching them. And God is not like that. He's not. He just wants us to approach him because he loves us, because he wants our attention. He wants us to be with him. And so because of that reason, we're able to go to him and we can go crying. We can go upset. We can go angry. He just wants us to come. So if you're out there and you're listening and you feel like you have to get it all together and, well, you know, I've heard people say, you know, I'm going to go to church as quick as I get me together. Well, you can't get you together.
Amen.
You know, you can't, you can't get ready. You know, many times we go to work and we ain't ready to work. But we go because we know we have to be there. And so that's the same mind we need to use when we approach Christ. We need to be able to say, you know what, I'm going because I know I need to be there. And once you get there and in his presence and be honest and say, Lord, here I am. I need washing. I need cleansing. He already knows what you've been through. He already knows what you went through. He already knows what you're going to go through. Just go ahead because he's faithful and just to forgive us.
Amen. Amen. You got any thoughts on that, Sister Rocky Thunder?
Sister Thunder. I just totally agree. Just come as you are. You can't, you know, cleanse yourself. You have to let God cleanse you. You have to have that faith and just come as you are.
Mm-hmm.
You
know,
I mean, that's how we come down here every Saturday to the Midnight Hour Radio Show. I mean, I make preparations, but I don't make preparations of how I'm going to approach the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
I let it flow freely out of me. However God see fit for me to bring a message across or for us to bring it across together as a team, we're going to bring it across. And Brother Michael just brought it up. He said, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. Mm-hmm. And the last part say to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's 1 John 1:9. That means basically that we can't cleanse ourselves like Brother Michael said.
Mm-hmm.
You're listening to Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show. You have to lean on Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
You have to let him give you the strength to walk away from your afflictions. That's what the preachers like to call them, especially down in the South, afflictions.
Your afflictions.
Yeah.
But you know what, Brother Martin, that last word, unrighteousness, you have to know. Now, if you don't think what you're doing is right, then there's no point in going.
Absolutely.
So you have to know when you're not right. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people, you know, if you're doing something and you know it's not right, he's faithful and just to cleanse you of that. Now, if until you realize that your unrighteousness is what it is, then there's, you know, there's no point in coming to him, and you're coming to him as if he owes you something because you've made a decision. But you come to him humble because you know that what you've done is not right. And that's all of us.
And I think that, Brother Michael, it's funny that you bring that up. I think that is a big thing that's going on in the church right now. so many people walking around inside the church like they holier than now.
Mm-hmm.
But when they outside the church, they might be at the club at 12 o'clock Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
But on Sunday morning at 8 o'clock, they at church acting like they better than everybody
mm-hmm.
else,
mm-hmm.
dressing better than everybody else. I hate to put it like this, but won't you take off the mink coat and sell it and help somebody who ain't got clothes to wear in that
yes.
same church? I hate to put it like that.
Some people have, but you know, some people have beat that demon, but they haven't beat the demon of being mean. Some people don't, you know, some people don't drink, smoke, go to clubs. I don't do that. It's just me and Jesus. But then you're mean, can't speak to you, you're snapping, you always in check mode. You know, you can't laugh about nothing. All those to me doesn't exhibit a Christ-like attitude, you know. So a lot of people have an issue with being mean is wrong.
Absolutely.
Flat out. And a lot of people have a severe issue with that, you know. Okay, fine, you don't do the club thing, that's fine or whatever. But at the same time, if you can't speak or if someone speak to you or you always in check mode all the time, that's what you need to bring to God and say, okay, is this Christ-like? Is this how? Because you still have to draw people with that love and that kindness, you know?
Right, absolutely.
And
amen.
We haven't came that far. All of us are, most of us are a prayer away from that person that we're
right.
trying to witness to. We're just a prayer away.
If you out there and you feeling down tonight, you listen to Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show, turn to Jesus right now and say, Lord, cleanse my soul. Let me lay my burdens on you. We're going to listen to some Yolanda Adams on the Midnight Hour Radio Show, Gospel Creations. This shall pass.
Yes.
Shall pass.
Yes, yes, yes.
This too shall pass. Yolanda Adams. Strength comes from the Lord God when you seek in him. Mm-hmm. A lot of people believe that you listen to the Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio so that they can bring the strength like we was talking about earlier. Mm-hmm. But you got to lean on God to have the strength. Isaiah 40, 28, verse 31. Have you not known, have you not heard, the Lord is everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. Mm-hmm. He gives power to the faint.
Yes.
And to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even you shall faint and be weary, and young men shall be fall exhausted, but they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength.
Yes.
They shall mount up wings like eagles. Mm-hmm. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Mm-hmm. Isaiah 40:28, verse 31.
That song that we just heard is just awesome, and knowing that the verse you just read, Myron, it just went right with that song, because when you realize that you will, if you wait on the Lord, he will renew your strength. So what you're going through is going to pass. You know, it's there now, but it won't be there always. And that's an awesome verse right after that wonderful ministry from Yolanda Adams. This shall pass. This shall go away. So this is not your life. So whatever predicament or situation that you're in now, and it may not be what you would like to be in, but you have to believe that better is on the way.
Amen.
You have to believe that.
Amen. Lift up your head, where if it's a death you're dealing with in the family, if it's a loved one who left you. A lot of people get discouraged when they lean too much on a person and don't put God first. If they left you right now, you laying there suicidal. I've been there before. I'm not speaking about it. I'm not judging. It was God that pulled me out of there. If you sitting praise there and you're addicted to drugs right now, lift your head up and say, Lord, I know this too shall pass. I will put my faith in you. There is no greater love than that of the love of God, because he created us all. He created the earth. He created the heavens. He created the angels. He created man. This too shall pass. We're going to take it to on Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show to some Smokey Norfolk, No Greater Love.
Do you mind if I testify and tell you of the goodness of my Lord? Share some of what he's done for me. How he's opened up so many doors. You may look at me from the outside and think I got here on my own, but there's no way that you could ever know how much grace and mercy I've been shown. Oh, if you look into my eyes, you see life has tried to get the best of me. But I know the giver of life personally. He's the reason that I sing. His name is Jesus, and he loves me. And I know this, 'cause he died for me and he rescued me. There's no greater love in the world. His name loves me, and I know this, 'cause he said it to me when he rescued me. There's no greater love.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Smokey North for No Greater Love on Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show. 1 Chronicles 16:11. Seek ye the Lord and his strength. Seek his presence continually. Continually. Brother Michael.
No greater love. We continue to seek that love that cuts off and that love that stops and that love that is not a certain. You know, we're on websites, we're on social chats, we're on all kind of meet and greets and Christian date and date of this and date of that. But that no greater love that will not stop. And it's free.
That's right.
And you can feel it when all that other love is gone. And I know I got witnesses out there because I'm a witness. When all that other love is gone, the love of God, it's free and you can feel it. And you know that you, the best thing about it, Sister Thunder, the best thing about it is that you don't have to be, you don't have to have 25 titles to receive it.
Right.
And it's so much of God's love that he's not going to, You don't have all. I know you think you got all of it, Brother Myron.
No,
but it's enough that I feel so full that you feel so full and you feel so full. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
I challenge you today, if you're out there, you know, you haven't been to no local assembly tomorrow. Make it even if it's just that one day. Just make it that one day. Go with grandma. Go with mama who gets up and goes and says goodbye to you and comes back. Go with her this Sunday. Go with grandma this Sunday. Go with auntie. Just even to step foot into his house and to say, God, I thank you.
For being here.
Yes, loving me when I didn't love myself or even when I don't. Don't let nobody talk you out of it because your relationship with God is your relationship.
And a lot of people feel intimidated when they go into church because they ain't got the right clothes or they don't have a lot of money. Well, Psalms 119:23 says, even though princes sit plotting against me, your servant will mediate on your statutes. What that means is that when you go to church and praise God, you don't got to have a lot of money. You just bring yourself as you are.
Mm-hmm.
You might be sitting next to a millionaire or somebody in a $500 suit or a pair of shoes. Because God knows, I got to bring this up. In Cleveland, a lot of churches is like that. Mm-hmm. A fashion show. I keep saying that for a reason. Because we ain't there to be at the BET Awards or act like it is. We there to serve God.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, I feel, forget that. And that's what chase a lot of people out of the church. What you think about that?
I think a lot of times it is. It's a perception. You know, there's a difference in being blessed and being a show-off. And there's a difference. You have some people that are blessed and because God has brought them from somewhere. And then you have those ones that are there to, you know, because to them it's a runway and it's a bunch of lights and a bunch of, you know, see me, love me. But at the same time, there are churches that are even in the community, as you can see, some of them, a lot of them have moved to the as you are. You know, you have some churches that are that, you know, don't even all the way from the pastor down. It's come on in. You know, they may have a dress down Sunday or whatever, but whatever the case is, pray, ask God to lead you to that place that you need to be at tomorrow, because the time is not going to be what it used to be. So you need to get in while you can now, you know.
Amen.
Get in now.
Right, amen.
He said, you don't know when that hour going to come.
No,
but
you don't.
You got a faith in my son, Jesus Christ, then you're going to be all right. I mean, I don't know the exact scripture there because I make sure I study. Matthew 17:20, he said to them, because of your little faith, for truly I say to you, if you have faith like a grain of a mustard seed, you will say to the mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. And I say Matthew 17:20 again, and we spoke on this before, because I want you to know that no matter where you at right now, what you're doing right now, if you need to leave the club smoking a joint and come outside and pray, do it. Mm-hmm. If you need to put the crack pipe down and come outside and do it. If you need to get out the bed from having sex, get up out the bed and pray to God. Whatever your needs is right now, God is there, like Brother Michael said, or Sister Rocky said. Sister Rocky, you want to say anything?
Just like you said, Brother Myron, just get up out the bed, get up, period, you know, and just pray. Exactly.
The Bible is free.
Yes, right.
The Word of God is free.
Yes.
Your soul and your salvation is free because Jesus died on the sins to save you. I don't mean to sound like no old gospel preacher, but you know what? You know what? It's free. The salvation of God is free.
It is. Amen. It doesn't cost anything.
You ain't got to have no Benz and no Cadillac.
No.
You ain't got to have no $1,000 suit and no $200 hairdo.
Right.
You ain't got to have no Versace, no whatever.
And it doesn't have to be cleared by people.
That's right.
You know, you don't have to have permission to reach Jesus.
Amen.
You understand? You don't have to have nobody stand in front of you or push you in the, you know, push behind you to reach him. It's a free walk. Free walk, and he just stands there with his arms open, waiting. He's not gonna pull you, you know, and show up in 35 dreams. It's free. You've heard it. You've heard the word. Just go straight to him.
Amen. Well, you know, God bless you out there. I want to encourage you to do what Brother Michael said. You listen to Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show. I want to encourage you to find a church home, whatever you're going through tonight.
Yes.
I want you to go to God in the morning. I want you to seek Jesus in his holy name. I want you to say, Jesus, if you sitting there discouraged at night, I want you to just keep calling out the name. This was how they used to do it in the old church. Jesus, Jesus.
Right.
They
it's
used to have you on your
name.
Knees.
Yes, they did.
Jesus
yes,
is power in the
did.
Name. Jesus, Jesus,
yeah.
Jesus. Call out his holy name. Call him until he give you the strength to get up in the morning and go to church and listen to the word of God. And
right.
Don't be afraid.
No.
Just have a faith of a seed of a mustard seed. Matthew 17:20. And God will help you and bring you where you need to be. He will change your life.
Yes, he will.
And he will bring you out of a dark place into a light place.
Yes, he will.
You listen to Gospel Creations on the Midnight Hour Radio Show. Until next week, we're going to take you out with Karen Clark Shear.
Oh, yes.
Yes, another Clark.
Yes, yes, yes.
Secret,
yes, yes, yes.
Secret places.
Yes, God
Amen.
Bless you.
See you next week.
A place where I can go.